Coast. Mm-hmm. Nasty weather here on the West Coast as well. And tomorrow morning, it's only going to get worse for people when they wake up.
Yeah, you know, we're already starting to see very light freezing rain, but it's going to become more widespread by tomorrow morning and heavier. And just this little bit of light freezing rain is already creating a glaze on the roads. And it doesn't take much to cause problems on the roads. But then once it starts to get heavier, not only are you concerned about icy conditions on the roads, but then you start to worry about that weight on the power lines and the tree limbs that could lead to eventual power outages. So we'll be watching that very closely as we go through the day tomorrow. The good news is the latest forecast models that just came in have backed off a little bit on the amount of moisture that will be moving through the valley. But still, we're going to be looking at significant ice totals, half an inch to three quarters of an inch for much of the valley. So winter storm round two underway right now. Scattered sleet and freezing rain, basically all just freezing rain at this point overnight. But it is on the light side and again scattered. By tomorrow morning, we're going to be looking at ice storm conditions for most of the valley, all up and down the valley, through at least the early part of the day tomorrow. By tomorrow night, we'll try to transition to more of just plain rain, but because of all the snow that fell on parts of the valley today, and then just thanks to that gorge wind keeping things so cold, the thaw out will be a very slow one. And so that means icy roads could persist even into Sunday night. So I do have an update for you. Winter storm warnings have now been canceled for the valley, but now we are under an ice storm warning instead. And that's because we've had that switch to freezing rain. You can see that highlighted in purple all up and down the valley for Portland Metro. And as you head east, and then it changes to pink here. And that's where we had the winter storm warnings. I'll show that to you in just a second. For the valley, it goes until 6 p.m. You drop south between Salem and Eugene. And it goes until 4 p.m. because we should see conditions start to warm up a little bit more there. But don't forget, there's several inches of snow on the ground. That can act like an ice box. And even though temperatures may be going up, the roads can stay icy and slushy even through the night. So what we'll be watching for very closely tomorrow. You head east, the gorge has already picked up 6 inches, if not more, of snow. We're looking at totals that could be up near a foot by tomorrow. So another round of snow moving in. We have winter storm warnings here until Monday morning because temperatures here are going to struggle to get above freezing, just period. East winds start to crank again, and so the farther west you go through the gorge, the stronger they'll be. 20 to even 40 mile an hour winds, but we could see higher gusts along western ends of the gorge. And so that again mainly in the form of snow tomorrow, but we could see a glaze of ice by tomorrow night, and that could cause so many problems along stretches of I-84. This is what it looks like out there near Hood River, and you can see already snow covered there, but with a glaze of ice on top, it'll make things worse. So metro area in the upper 20s. This is Mount Hood Meadows, and I wanted to show you, it's pretty quiet up there right now. We did pick up several inches of snow, but this just goes to show you how much has changed. So right now in the valley, temperatures in the upper 20s. You go into the gorge and we're in the teens, but you go up in elevation, temperatures are going up. We're at 32 degrees at the base of Mount Hood Meadows. That warm air is already gliding over the colder air that's in place, and that's why we've seen that switch from snow to freezing rain, because temperatures are warm enough that we're starting to see it melt above us and freeze on contact. Skamania picking up quite a bit of snow there, and then South Valley. This is a look out towards our Western Oregon University camera, where temperatures are still in the 20s and we still have snow on the ground there. So more rain showers moving in, freezing rain, more developing to the south and west, but it's going to be tomorrow that we'll see the heavier action. So tomorrow morning, especially late morning between 9 and noon, showers pick up in intensity, things get very icy, and that's going to stick around through the early part of the afternoon. Tomorrow evening, it all starts to taper off with better conditions by Monday. So your Sunday forecast, temperatures will eventually get into the upper 30s, but keep in mind, tomorrow's highs won't come until probably tomorrow night. So ice storm warnings in effect tomorrow. Very icy conditions. I think the worst of it will probably be from morning until at least the early part of the afternoon. So conditions just getting worse as we go later into the day. Cold showers Monday, and then all eyes on the next system for the middle part of the week that could bring in yet more snow for the valley.
Next system, another one?
Yeah, another one. Tuesday night to Wednesday.
Winter is here, no doubt.
Sure is.
All right, Kristen, thank you. All right, let's talk about sports now. Wild card weekend is here. We're